Why is the dog barking? They're leaving. Oh, no, he's here. Give me a minute. What are you doing? There's no quiet place. 15 and a 30. I ain't in no hurry. They're gone. My singing scared them away. Hey guys, it's Lacey, and you may be asking yourselves, why is Lacey in a car? Why is she filming a video in a car? I'm asking myself, I'm one person, only Lacey, but I'm asking myself that same question. Honestly, I don't really know. People just keep moving in and out of my house and moving things all day, and there's dogs barking, so I can't film outside. And this is the best I can do right now, and I really want to film this video, so yeah. Anyways, the video is me reading my middle school letter, as you probably can tell from the title. But if you watched my last video, you watched me read my freshman year letter to myself. And this is probably going to be even more cringy than that. So if you haven't checked that video out, please go check it out. I will link it below. But I'm excited for this one, so we'll see if you should even watch that one. This one might be better. But let's open this up. We wrote this in 8th grade history class, and I remember my teacher being like, take it seriously, and I'm pretty sure I didn't take it seriously. So, if I didn't, I'm sorry. But yeah, it is really hot in this car, so we'll see. Welcome. I've been expecting you. I graduated yesterday. Yay, pledge. Oh, I had to say the pledge with two of my friends in front of everyone at graduation, and they told me like the day before, and I was like, how was I selected to do this? But yeah, and then I said sealed Thursday, June 6th, 2013. What day is today? Today is June 19th, Monday, June 19th, 2017. So this is over 4 years ago. Wow. Oh, I hand wrote it. Oh, wait, I'm so cute. I used different color pens. This is very interesting. I'm terrified. Oh, okay, I'm gonna read, sorry. Okay, so Thursday, May 30th, 2013 was the day I actually wrote the letter. Dear my future self, times are hard, but you will move on. 8th grade, I was diagnosed with a rare disease after they thought that I had cancer. So I had a very rough middle school experience, not gonna lie, but things are better and I have moved on, so. Homework is long, but you will get it done, and I have. Never give up on yourself or anyone else. I never give up on anyone. If anything, people give up on me. You can keep going. now that I am grown up, you can look back at all the good times in middle school. Like the time you fell using Kathleen's crutches in gym, or even that time Jonathan was sitting in the portables hallway with his computer and you stepped over him and fell and knocked your own books down. That was hilarious. It was outside my social studies class. I was coming back from English, and I tripped over him, and I dropped everything, and then my teacher came out and was like, you alright? I was like, yeah, and then he, like, fixed his whiteboard. I was like, thanks. Oh, yeah. Then Mr. Dusek asked if everyone was alright, fixed his whiteboard, then goes back into his room. Okay, yeah, so I told you the story. Oh, Mr. Dusek, how much we love you. He was one of my favorite teachers. I actually loved him a lot. Do people still call you Barbie? Some people call me Barbie, not very often though. Mama Lace, yes, I'm still Mama Lace. Barney. Why was I called Barney? Oh, never mind. I had this outfit that I wore, blue and purple and green. Am I colorblind? Or just okay, but yeah, that's why. Blondie, yes, I'm still Blondie. Do you remember Mr. Tabus yelling at you for not sweeping? Yes. So we had this lunch period with everyone in our class, and we were supposed to take turns sweeping based on like color shirt or like when your birthday is, or like they change it every day. It was my turn. I was really, 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 really sick, and I could not do it. Like, I physically like could not stand up. I was like, I need to go home, like whatever. So my friend said she'd do it, but my friend forgot to do it. He noticed that we didn't sweep, and then he started yelling at me because it was my day, and he like thought that I rolled my eyes at him, which I didn't. I just very expressive. maybe I did. I don't know. I don't think so. And he threatened to give me a detention, and I was like, all right, bud, you need to chill. You need to chill. He's like, you know what I do with kids that roll their eyes at me? I give them detention. And I was like, okay, like, give me detention. But he didn't, so. Yeah. A cockroach was just thrown at me. Didn't know there were cockroaches in my middle school, but that's great. I don't remember that. Maybe I just blocked out the terrible past. Washington, D.C. was a blast with Kathleen and Chloe. Oh yeah, that trip in 8th grade was amazing. Oh my gosh. We roomed together and it was just hilarious. And I remember, like, my one friend was showering and, like, made a weird noise and we thought she was, like, a mermaid. Oh, that trip. Things I learned, things I didn't learn. Okay. I loved Mrs. Fetty throwing my Walzer behind the couch in the hotel. Okay, so I had an allergy pill and the teachers had to, like, give us our medicines because we were too young to do it ourselves, apparently. And so she gave me one, but she dropped it. And she's like, you can't take it. It's a hotel floor. It's disgusting. So she was like, okay. So she just threw it behind the couch. And then she's like, no one saw that, okay? And this is a teacher. And I was like, I love you. That was great. Okay, and then I switched color pens from black to blue. I said, there are just so many things. It's so hard to let go of the past, but even harder to let go of the present. Why am I so deep? Oh, whoo. But the hardest is looking and waiting for the future. Some of my best friends... Oh, that just dramatically changed, but wow, that was really deep. Maybe I'm a poet and I don't know it. Actually, none of it rhymed, so no. But some of my best friends are Isabel, Julia, Kathleen, Bonnie, Sophia, sometimes Chloe, that's a joke, don't worry, Allison, sometimes too, and Izzy, yeah, but she moved schools, oh, that's sad, okay, I looked my high school experience, it's supposed to say I loved, but I said I looked my high school experience, good, even though the hard times, like Tuesday, December 18th, 2012, finding out I have linearmorphia, or Saturday, December 22nd, 2012, starting chemotherapy for the linearmorphia. So that was the disease I have. But, yeah. Super emotional, Lacey. Super emotional. I wish I could go back to my middle school days. I do. I really loved 7th grade in particular. That was the best year of my entire life, because that was before at least most things in my life kind of went downhill, but it's okay. I hope high school brings you, me, the same. Keep on the work and keep doing whatever you do best. P.S. Make the most out of every experience. Love always, yourself, Lacey. And then, wow, that was kind of sad that it's over. Okay, and then on the sides, in the margins, I put little notes, and I said, and great job being student of the month in 8th grade, April 2013. I was student of the month? Oh, in Spanish! And I got the special chair. So, I had this teacher, Mrs. White, for Spanish, and we were her 8th period angels. That's what she called us, because she loved us. And I was student of the month, and so she had this giant, like, recliner chair in the back of the room. So if you were student of the month, you could just sit in the really super comfy chair. And it was the best thing ever. And then I put like an arrow, like drawing, or I said like Izzy and then like her last name. I said like the school she went to, but I said remember her. I was like, well, how could I not remember Izzy? She's like my other half. Yeah, so there's also this little poem that I'm going to read because it was in the letter, so I feel weird not reading it to you. But it says bits and pieces. Bits and pieces, bits and pieces. People. People are important to you. Or people important to you. Can't even read, jeez. People unimportant to you cross your life. Touch it with love and move on. There are people who leave you and you breathe a sigh of relief and wonder why you came into contact with them. There are people who leave you and you breathe a sigh of remorse and wonder why they had to go and leave such a gaping hole. True. Children leave parents, friends leave friends, acquaintances move on. People change homes. People grow apart, enemies hate and move on, friends love and move on. You think of many people who have moved in and out of your hazy memory. You look at those present and wonder. I believe in God's master plan in our lives. God moves people in and out of each other's lives, and each leaves a mark on their own. You find you are made up of bits and pieces of all who have ever touched your life. You are more because of them, and would be less if they had not touched you. Pray that you accept the bits and pieces in humility and wonder, and never question and never regret. Bits and pieces, bits and pieces. Anonymous. And then my teacher wrote, "Dear class of 2013, thank you for a very memorable year and all the best in high school and beyond, Mr. Dusick." And then in the margins of this, I wrote, "Bonnie and I made a puppet show, which we did for World War II, like unit. We made a nurse and a soldier out of sock puppets. We did a little puppet show in front of the class, which was super embarrassing but super funny. And I loved it." And then I said, "We are his favorite seventh period class." We are his favorite seven. Period seven. Oh my gosh. "We are his favorite period seven. I need to go back to sleep. I have not slept a lot in days. I had too many graduation parties." But yeah. And then I said, "Received." And I spelled it R-E-S-E-I-V-E-D. Thursday, May 30th, 2013. Yeah. Interesting. Can we take a moment to appreciate my handwriting? This is my prime. Honestly, I think my handwriting just got worse. Like, let's compare. I think it was better then. But yeah. Okay, well, thank you guys so much for watching, and I hope you guys enjoyed this super cringy video. If you did, please give it a thumbs up, and please comment down below telling me your favorite middle school experience. And if you're younger than middle school, tell me what you're excited about for middle school, because middle school is honestly a great time and you guys have nothing to worry about. And subscribe, because I make videos on Mondays. I love you all, and I will see you next Monday. I love you all. Bye! I said I love you all twice, but it just shows how much I really love you guys. I'm so hot and so sweaty. We're just gonna... Still barking. Still barking. If it stops one more time, I'm gonna scream. Okay. It needs to stop stopping.